What I learned from this experience so far, especially when I'm doing the butterfly service, is that you look more at the beauty of nature.
Beautiful. Oh, there's a broken
yeah. Here's a butterfly on my hat.
One of the longest surveys that we've actually done in the park is butterfly surveys.
That is a wild indigo dusky wing.
Wild indigo.
And we do these butterfly surveys in order to monitor pollinator populations at several sites around the park. Because we have the rusty patch bumblebee that's been added to the endangered species list, we figured in tandem with these butterfly surveys, we would start doing and searching for the rusty patch bumblebee when we go out to these sites.
So we pulled ourselves together, we pulled our resources together, and we created the Ohio Bee Atlas, which is a citizen science project, so that we have a great picture of where the bees are in Ohio, in the hopes that we find the rusty patch bumblebee.
We went out with my roommate, Carlin, who is a bee fanatic, knows everything about bees. She's great, she's awesome.
What we have here is Bombas bimaculatus, which is the two-spotted bumblebee, which is another bee that we would expect to see in this area.
We caught a lot. We had to net them, put them in the little jar and stuff like that, identify them.
So what we have here, this angry ball of Bombas, is the same guy that we had last week, which was Bombas fervidus. This is the more uncommon bumblebee that we saw, actually, and this is relatively on decline as well. But you can see the pollen that she's carrying in her pollen baskets there. When you see that, you know that's a female. Only females are equipped with that pollen-carrying tool.
And then later today, what we did was we went and counted butterflies. Look at species, how many we have, flowering plants and things like that.
Collaborative. Okay, yeah, he's in there. Yeah.
Okay. Oh, okay, there you go. I really liked catching the bees and butterflies because before this, I couldn't really identify like the different species, but now like I can go out and just kind of like be like, oh, that's Bombas impatiens or something like that. And I think it's really unique to be able to like categorize the bees and the butterflies and the plants.
What's a female? Because it has
it's
little
a female?
Lumps on its wings. Yeah.
You see a butterfly whizzing by. It's a rare butterfly, a common butterfly. You observe it and you see the little bit of personality each living thing has in its own general life. And it makes you appreciate more about what the National Park Service does, and this makes you want to get into things like conservancy.
Oh, wow.
These kids do understand that it is relevant, it's very important, and that there is a little bit of seriousness to when we do these surveys because we do need this data, we do need their help, and we do need to save this bumblebee.